Dear students, in continuation to my last video, in this video I will discuss about some more elements in terms of your voice and more elements when it comes to the role of paralinguistics. So as we discussed in our last video about quality and volume. So if your volume is very low, then also you are deemed to be less prepared for your presentation, and thus it is very much needed that you improve your voice quality or your speaking style in order to be a good orator. Now coming to the third element in paralinguistics, that is pace or rate. So rate is the number of words which we speak per minute. How many words you use in a minute to speak, how fast can you speak, that is what you call rate. It differs from person to person and from 80 to 250 words per minute. As you can see, the range usually is from 80 to 250 words per minute that has been calculated. Now the normal rate or good or ideal rate is from 120 to 150 words per minute. One should practice so as to fit in this reasonable limit. If you want your pace or rate to be good, then you should try to lie in between this range. If a person speaks too slowly and monotonously, that is, uses no pauses or is just very fast, then also the people lose interest in his speech. And also, if the person is very much slow, then also people will lose interest in his speech. So it is very important to maintain the right balance in terms of the number of words while making your presentation. And this can be very much done with practice. Now moving further, we will discuss about another element of paralinguistics, that is pitch. Now pitch refers to the number of vibrations per second of your voice. So how you can see your voice raise and fall with the change in the content and the topic that you are discussing is pitch. With the effective use of pitch, you can find your delivery to be very much pleasing in terms of the overall sound impact that your delivery creates. The rise and fall of the voice shows various emotions. So you can use your pitch to express various emotions, expressions, and communicate best with your non-verbal expressions. If one is joyous, excited, or angry, then the pitch automatically becomes high. So if you're having an adrenaline rush, you are in very much excitement, very happy, then you start talking in a high pitch, and a well balanced pitch also results in a clear and effective tone. So if your pitch is very much balanced in terms of the highs and the lows, like if you're talking about something that is very much serious or sad or sensitive, then you will slightly lower your pitch. And if something that you want to motivate the crowd or you want them to, you know, get very much excited and get pumped up, then you start raising your pitch. Pitch is also influenced by the air supply. If one runs out of air, one cannot control the pitch of voice. See, this very much happens with people who are into music and who are into singing especially, that because of their air supply being deprived, then they actually cannot be at very high pitch for long. So for this you need to practice on your breathing so that you can use your pitch effectively. Pitch can be used in different varieties to hold the listener's attention, and you can use your pitch as per the content so as to get your audience attention grabbed towards you. Avoid raising of pitch while ending the sentence. See, a raised pitch denotes that something new is coming, or some new topic, or some new expression, or this thing is going to continue. So if you are ending your presentation, if you are ending your delivery, if you are on the verge of conclusion or summarizing, then you should lower your pitch so that people get an idea that, okay, now you're going to finish your content or your delivery. The vocal pattern that is raising the pitch is called pitching. So this act of raising or lowering the pitch is called pitching up and denotes the unfinished speech or matter. So if you are raising your pitch, then this means that something more is coming and people start waiting for or wanting for something more. So while you are ending your speech, it is very important that you do not raise your pitch. The next element that we will discuss is articulation. So articulation means the clarity in the voice. A clearly articulated message shows competence and confidence. So articulation means how clear you are while using the words or while describing the message that you have in your mind. If you're fumbling in between, then you might not be very much clear in terms of what you have to tell your audience. So one should speak in such a way that all the words are understood by the listener. You should try to be very much clear in terms of your pronunciation so that people can hear your said words clearly. If one speaks sloppily or mispronounces the words, the listener easily gets distracted and sometimes the meaning too changes. It at times happens that very common that words are having very slight difference in their meanings and in their pronunciation. So while you're pronouncing a certain word and it is spelled in a wrong way or it is pronounced in a wrong way, then the meaning entirely changes. So you have to be very much careful that you do not pronounce the words wrong. So moving further, we will discuss the next elements in our upcoming video. Thank you.